She's not what you'd expect. She's tough and feisty, but gentle and tender. She makes millions and gives millions to the poor. She cries, she laughs, she teaches, she comforts. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Okay, so there's some shows that are completely set apart that I'm more excited about to talk to you about than others. This is one of those shows. We're gonna have a very passionate discussion about one tiny little itsy bitsy thing that is going to make you more money. Yes, it's going to make you more money, make you more valuable, reduce your stress, reduce the stress in others. Oh, I can't wait to get into today's topic. Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show, where we help you define success for your life. Custom made, a custom fit suit of success for you. And I'm not talking about those old suits that, you know, were pretty much worn in the 90s. People aren't really wearing them that much anymore. Well, I guess in some parts of the world, but you know what I'm saying? A custom made, tailored fit shoe of success for you. Do you know that there is one for you? You don't have to live somebody else's definition of success. I don't have to live somebody else's definition of success. But you have at least got to define what it is for you. There's something calling out of you. There's something you were put on this earth to do. And today, I'm gonna show you how to go at it. I'm so excited for you and I to talk about this. I have to read you this quote. Initiative is doing the right thing without being told. That is Victor Hugo. He's an author. So here I got a small little list of things that, yes, one tiny little itsy bitsy little skill, whether you are a third grader or even a three-year-old, can learn this skill all the way up to in your 90s, or you might be 120 watching today's program. No matter where you are in life, this one skill can change every single area of your life. Not only that, but if you're listening today and you're an employer or you are somebody that manages other people, this is one skill you want to look for in the people that you're managing, the people that you are leading, especially if right now you are doing job interviews. Hello? Yeah. This is one thing you must find in the person you're thinking about hiring. Let me see if you can guess it. First of all, it will increase your value. It will make you more money. It will give you more confidence. It will help you earn massive bonuses, raises, and promotions. It will turn you into a true leader. It will increase your productivity. And this skill will actually accidentally, whether you want to be or not, might birth you into becoming a millionaire or at least an entrepreneur, a successful entrepreneur. What is the skill set? Initiative. People who have initiative. It's like singing me a love song after I've been far away from my husband for too long. Initiative. Oh my gosh, it is such a powerful, small little skill set that has so many beautiful benefits to it that when I encounter someone that has it, my trust in that person intensifies greatly. You see, if you want to succeed out there in the marketplace, you have to build trust with people. And trust is not built by saying, "Trust me! Trust me, I'll take care of it." No. In fact, you kind of almost have to be aware of the people who say, "Trust me, it'll work," or "Trust me, I can do it." Yeah, that makes me a little cautious. But initiative, what does it look like? What does it sound like? What does it act like? The actual literal definition of the word initiative is defined as to the initiation of action independent of outside influence or control. I want to tell you a story of my husband's cousin who she first started working for us when she was 18 years old. She just graduated from high school. She graduated like 6 months early and she was living with us and she had lived with us for many years. But in the midst, we had started DaniJohnson.com. And so here we have this, we birthed this little internet company and you know, we're working out of our house. You know, I'm doing business consulting out of my master bedroom, which was a tiny little room. You know, we then eventually moved it into our barn, and then eventually we grew out of the barn and moved into an office, you know, that today, you know, has whatever. We're all over the world today. But the point is that Laura Lee, was somebody that she was a young kid. She hated the thought of ever talking to somebody on the phone. She was very quick at playing cards and quick with numbers, right? But what was that going to do inside of our company? Well, the only position we had available for her was to answer the phones. She was terrified. She actually even, I think she threw up one time when it came time to like having to pick up the phone. She was so nervous about talking to another human on the other side of the phone, which was hilarious, right? She grew up in a big family. She had 5 kids plus a mom and dad, plus all the cousins and uncles who all lived very, very close by. I mean, it wasn't like she was this isolated homeschooled kid who never had a social life. No, she was a soccer player, you know what I mean? Went to a big high school, but ooh, her heart would just pound, her stomach would turn in knots if it came time to answer in the phone. Well, she was very fast with some things and other things she would avoid. What we noticed about her, and she used to drive her manager crazy. As a company began to build, this girl we saw had so much talent, yet she had no initiative. Talent without initiative is going to get fired. Talent with initiative is going to grow and flourish and prosper to great things. And so here we began to work on and have some discussions with Laura Lee concerning initiative. Because this is what she'd do. You give her a task, she finishes it fast, and she sits there and twiddles her thumb waiting for somebody else to come and tell her what to do. You see, having no initiative is the person who waits for someone to tell them what to do next. I finished my stuff, now I sit, twiddling my thumbs. That is somebody that has to be micromanaged. That somebody actually is teaching that they have to be managed and they're not rising up into leadership. So we began to foster and father or even mother initiative inside of Laura Lee. And it was not easy. And I'm not sure that if she wasn't a relative and that I hadn't been a spiritual mother to her already at that point for about 5 years, I'm not so sure that I would have made the kind of investment that I did into her, but we did. And there was pretty much three of us that continued to kind of teach her and guide her what initiative looked like. What does initiative sound like? One of the simple things, and we wrote it in the book called Grooming the Next Generation for Success, was having your child finish the task. And what you train them to say is, I'm finished with that. What's next? I'm done with that. Is there something else that you would like me to do? So not waiting for someone to come to you, but going. My son Roman has that incredible skill. He's had it since he was young. And this has helped him get promoted in many different things in life. The guy at 15 bought his first house. He's been an investor in cattle, gold, and silver. Now in stocks, he's learning how to invest into stocks. Talking about wanting to buy another rental property. He's not even out of the house. He's now just 17. He's managing his own rental property for 2 years. Okay, his taxes. Hello, he's doing his taxes. Wow, well, he's learning how to do his taxes, but if you were to look at his taxes, his return, you know, profit and loss statements, he's 17 years old. Why? Initiative. Initiative. How do you even come about buying that house? Initiative. He came to us at 15 with a business proposition about purchasing a house and did this whole presentation to us that was like, wow, he's 15. Okay, now, not all 5 kids are like this, okay, so don't get me wrong. And he's not a fluke, but not everybody has this kind of initiative that he does. But initiative can take a young person and help them to surpass their parents. It can take a young person who's working at the bottom in a corporation and have them surpass even the higher levels of management really fast. Initiative has very high value in the marketplace. So I want you to kind of look at your own life and look at, well, wait a second, where am I? What am I doing with initiative? Do I have initiative or am I waiting for people to tell me what to do? Do I only respond in crisis or do I actually look at things proactively and get a head start on some things so that I'm ahead in some places instead of behind or just where everybody else is? What does initiative look like in the home? What does it look like at work? And in your opinion, what kind of value does it have? But again, this is important. Look at you, look in the mirror. What does your initiative look like at home? I got a confession to make, okay? When my kids were little, I was just actually going through the grocery line day before yesterday, and I was looking, I walked by the diapers and went, thank God those aren't in my cart anymore. And then the bottles and the formula and all this stuff. And then, you know, our dog, we laid our dog down about a year ago, like, oh, thank God there's no more dog food in our. Yes, I miss Kona. And yes, I miss the kids being in diapers, but I do not miss those things in my shopping cart anymore. I don't miss that part at all anymore. But anyway, so when I was looking at this season of my life, because it kind of all brought me back, and I was like, oh, thank God that part of my life is over. Not that I didn't like it, I enjoyed it, but I'm glad that I have the benefit of being on the other side. Here was one. I purposely would leave some things out just to see if my husband would pick it up. That stinks. First of all, that's straight up manipulation. It is. That's straight up manipulation. That is not initiative, right? I felt so overworked. You know, I've got all these babies. I got two of them in diapers, and I got toddlers. I got little school-age kids. I mean, life was crazy. I've got a garden. I'm rolling out pasta, okay? I'm making fresh dough for bread and then homemade pies, and I'm just, you know, you can just see it. You know, I got one kip on one hip. I got a kid on my back. You know, I got laundry hanging in the backyard to save money on the electric bill. I got sweat coming down. I'm being freckled because of the sun. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, I was just, oh, it's all so hard, right? And I remember being such a brat, like such a brat, that I was laying down my initiative. I was laying it down going, forget it. I am not going to do this, and I'm not going to do that, and I'm not going to do this, and I'm not going to do that. I just made all this list of things that I wasn't going to do because I didn't feel appreciated enough. Ugh. Bad idea. Are you like that? Are there some places that you feel like, man, you got some really good, strong initiative, but it's not paying off yet? Listen, what you do today doesn't always pay off today. Sometimes it doesn't pay off tomorrow, but oh, Lord. I really regret that I even started that way of thinking. Why? That's a 98% way of thinking. That you're gonna hold back because you don't think you're being appreciated, because you don't think that it's gonna do something. You're holding back because what's the use anyway? It's really not gonna help all that much in the end anyway. Why am I gonna work so hard? That's a habit of a 98%er. And it will not help you to prosper. It will not build you to having the kind of reputation that you desire to have. It will not help you to prosper financially in your relationships, your health, because once you lay down initiative and you just start getting lazy for whether it's out of, you know, not feeling appreciative, so it's out of spite or it's in manipulation or it's just flat out laziness, it affects all the other areas of your life eventually. It affects it. I became depressed as a direct result of thinking like that and doing things like that. This is Dani Johnson. We're going to dive deep into this initiative.
Did you know you can see Dani Johnson live and in person? Go to DaniJohnson.com to find out about our next live event. First Steps to Success. Register today. Call 866-760-8255 or go to DaniJohnson.com/FSTS.
Imagine living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel made of waste material on top of old mining tunnels that could explode and sink your home at any moment. Imagine no water to drink, no safe place to raise your children, no food for your starving baby. Imagine that your kids can't learn to read because they have to work to support the family instead of going to school. Could you imagine living in that kind of fear and hopelessness? This is exactly what families are dealing with in the poverty-stricken village of Santa Pancha, Nicaragua. These families can barely meet their basic food, water, and housing needs. We are transforming that village. Be a part of this miracle. I want you to go to the website now and learn how you can help. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha. There you can join with other warriors against poverty and help bring a miraculous transformation to Santa Pancha. That's kingsransom.org, kingsransom.org.
If you knew you couldn't fail, what would you do with your life? Discover your own answer. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Do you like to be at the top of your game? Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. We're here every single day bringing you content to help you have not only a better day, but a more successful, a more fulfilled, a more purpose-filled day. And today we are talking about one tiny little skill that affects every area of your life and helps you to have a top-notch reputation, help you to become dependable, to help you to become one who gets picked for bonuses and promotions and high praises of those that are around you. Now, it doesn't happen overnight, but it will happen, and I promise you. So we're talking about the skill of initiative. So I was telling you earlier about Laura Lee. Well, Laura Lee, who had no initiative, then learned that muscle of initiative. Her confidence began to grow. Well, this woman ended up accomplishing so many of her greatest dreams and aspirations that she had that she thought were impossible simply from initiative. And this girl became incredibly highly valued, made a tremendous amount of money at a very young age, and traveled all over the world. And then that initiative took her to a place of even starting her own business. She has a clothing store. She works one day a week. She is also a mother of two. And her husband just won a political office. So, and how? Again, she helped her husband win that political race. All odds were against them in this town. And now he is the county assessor. So listen, initiative pays dividends. Initiative, the practice of initiative, you being one that has initiative, one that doesn't wait for people to tell you what to do, one that doesn't wait for someone to instruct you, but that you're in control because you're actually leading the way and you are stepping up and going the extra mile, makes you so dependable. And dependable people have great reputations. Dependable people take stress and pressure off of those that are around them, especially the work environment. So have you ever worked with someone who has initiative? We asked that question on Facebook, and we have some people who have come to join us today in the show to share their perspective on initiative. We have Elizabeth Dyer from Georgia. Elizabeth, have you ever worked with somebody with initiative, and how do you feel you rate on the card of initiative?
Well, luckily, yes, I have, because when you work with somebody that has initiative, they help push you to reach your own goals.
Yes. How so?
And they encourage you. They don't feel like they're competing with you. They're actually, you know, encouraging you to move forward.
How, though? How do you think that that's a fit, like that that's a verbal encouragement? Are you saying by their very example of how they are working?
Both, you know, both, absolutely. Examples are the most important, because if you see somebody doing something, you can tell yourself, I can do that too.
Yep. And it takes the right person, because another person can look at that person with initiative and go, they're just kissing the boss's feet, you know? They're just snubbing around, you know, just trying to get on the boss's good side. Some people look at someone with initiative and they have that opinion. Which is kind of,
that's very true.
It is, which is very sad. So it all depends on the person. So usually one that has initiative is inspired by somebody else's initiative. Someone that's lazy, someone that doesn't have a vision for their life, someone that isn't going anywhere in their life, they want to pull that guy with initiative down. So what about you? Have you ever encountered someone that has no initiative?
I do. As a business owner, I've unfortunately hired a person or two that didn't. And I can say working with them is draining, because you feel like you have to, your job then becomes simply telling them to do their job instead of continuing on, you know, with the other task at hand. Because my job is to build my business, to, you know, check on the books, to keep everything flowing, not just to watch one employee and say, you're done with that, let's move to the next job.
Gosh, I'm telling you, you know what I feel like? As you were just saying that, I've hired a couple who have no interest. Right away, I'm like, just pull over the crane with a giant piece of metal on it and drop it on top of my head. That's how painful it is to work with people who have no initiative.
Yes, it is.
Isn't it, Elizabeth? I mean, because look, you're taking such a risk on hiring somebody else. And when you have to slow everything down,
it becomes painful, and it hurts the company overall.
It does.
Just one person can drag an entire company down.
It's true.
Because they're taking money out, and if they're not working to do something that positively brings money in, there's no money to pay everybody.
No.
There's no money to pay all the bills.
Yep. So what's the answer, Elizabeth? What did you have to do with those couple of people that you hired that had no initiative?
Well, they're not working for me anymore.
Amen. Amen. I know I'm going to get some hate mail on that one. Someone's like, oh, Dani, you just said amen that she fired someone? Yep. And guess what? God fired them. Because there are laws in the greatest success book ever on how to prosper. And there are laws that if you break them, they break you. It's called the law of correction. That if you do not work with diligent hands, it says you will come into poverty. Bam! That means getting fired. Anyway, this is Dani Johnson. Thanks so much, Elizabeth. We'll continue after this.
Dani will be back with more expert business, money, and relationship advice to help you live the uncommon life. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
I just heard this amazing story. One of our clients had written us telling us that they had used job domination and unlimited success and has absolutely exploded their career. He said, Dani, I don't know where I'd be today without job domination and unlimited success. Listen, do you want more recognition from your coworkers? Do you want to be recommended to people all over the world? Do you want to be somebody that is highly sought after? Listen, if you're in a dead-end place where this gentleman found himself but then learned new strategies and changed everything in his work life, and obviously this has resulted in higher bonuses and pay raises, you're next. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Job Domination right now. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Job Domination. That's what you need. It's time for you to dominate the job market and break through the rut that you're in.
And now, back to the Dani Johnson Show.
Dragging people at work, like dragging them along, like trying to push them to get the job done, trying to remind them 17 times about a task. Like I said earlier, drop a crane that's carrying a giant piece of metal on top of my head. That's what it feels like. Yeah, it really does. But look, here's the flip side of it. If you're one that has initiative, and by the way, business owners have initiative. That's the only way they could have initiated in starting a business. They have to have initiative in order to start that business. And so entrepreneurs largely come with that characteristic already. And I know you want to succeed, and I know you don't want to stay the same, and I know you want to get out of a rut perhaps that you might be sitting in right now. And maybe if you feel like you're in a rut in your job and your vision in your job has become cloudy, it is time to muster up some initiative. It's a muscle, and it is one that needs to be practiced. And as you lift that muscle and you practice that muscle, I'm telling you, you're going to become so very valuable in the marketplace, and you'll be a stress reliever, not one that is piling stress upon the management inside the workplace. And those that relieve stress, those that are dependable, those that go the extra mile, I didn't say do extra hours, I said go the extra mile. Those who are really efficient and those that keep the initiatives of the management in mind. Those people, like, because the management and the boss and the owner, they have initiatives. They got things that got to be done every day. They've got goals that have to be accomplished each and every day to keep the business growing, to keep it prosperous, so we can keep employing people. And so if you keep the initiatives of the headship of the organization in your mind, then man, you're gonna become so efficient in what you're doing. You're gonna become so valuable, and you're gonna climb all the way through. In fact, we have Rebecca here joining us from Wisconsin. Since we're talking about initiative, Rebecca, what are your thoughts on initiative? When I asked earlier in the show, like, where do you grade yourself in there? Because it helps you get promoted or it helps you get fired. One or the other. Which side have you been on?
I've been promoted for my initiative, and actually I didn't have my initiative in until after I was promoted, and then I went on to school to get more knowledge on what I was promoted for.
Nice. Which takes initiative, that you were looking to get more education for yourself so that you could do better in your job. So you end up being promoted as a direct result of that. So how does it feel to have initiative?
It feels wonderful to have initiative. I mean, to be able to go to extra meetings and be able to continuously learn and be open to new ideas, it feels amazing. Some fail and some are great, but just to do it and to take that knowledge in is just a wonderful feeling.
Okay, versus the other side, because you've lived on the side of the fence where you had no initiative. What does that feel like?
That's not a good side of the fence at all. That side can really drain you down to nowhere.
It does, doesn't it? But what does it look like? What does it look like? So when you had no initiative, what did that actually look like?
Thank goodness I still lived at home and I had no initiative, and it was just bad because I just didn't do anything. I was just lazy and didn't put myself out there. I didn't graduate from high school. I had to go out and get my HSED and then go out and get my associates and my bachelor's later in life because I just didn't have the initiative the first time around.
Yep, yep. So obviously, no initiative is a struggle. I think that it is harder to have no initiative than it is to have initiative. What do you think about that? Because you've lived on both sides of the fence.
Oh, I know it's a lot harder not to have initiative.
Isn't that amazing? But isn't it weird that on the outside, it seems like it's easier, but it's not. It's actually harder. It makes our life so much harder. So were you dependable when you had no initiative?
No, I wasn't dependable at all.
What were your relationships like at home?
Not very good.
What would your parents say to you?
They lived with me, but I don't know how. I always tell my mom, I'm still wondering how you still have hair.
But what would they say to you? You know, would they say, hey, you need to get a job? You know, hey, you need to, did they make any, you know, advancements toward you of what you should be doing?
Yeah, they did. And then I would go out and I'd apply, but I would just not really try very hard
exactly.
or anything. So it would look like I was giving it some initiative when I really wasn't.
Exactly. Oh my gosh, I've seen people do that. I don't know why, but my stomach is turning right now. Because it is. It's like, well, I filled out an application. As though that is going to do something. Well, you know, I filled out 3 applications. No one's called me back. What does initiative look like there? Call them. Go face to face with them again. Write them a thank you card. Chase them down. That is initiative. But isn't it wild how once we get on the lazy train and once we just like completely forfeit all initiative at all, now we become victims. Now we think everyone's against us. Now we think nobody likes us. Now we start entertaining thoughts of I'm not good enough, I'm worthless, I'm not going anywhere in life. This is just how it is. My life just sucks and it always sucks. Did you used to think like that?
Yes, I did.
Can you believe that was you?
Yes, I can. At one point in my life, it was very rough, but I'll admit I can point out them years and remember them.
Gosh, and it feels so good not to be there anymore. Oh man, Rebecca, thanks so much for being transparent with us. And it's, you know, it's good to know because some people just think, well, it's either I was born with it or I wasn't. What caused you to change?
Actually, just working at my job for a while and I was bored doing the same old thing and it was just production in a factory and I wanted to go further in life. So in order to do anything, I had to continue my education, and now I have to continue to learn how to communicate better with higher people.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so it was taking action. It's like taking that first step, actually getting that job, and then you're going, hey, I'm not satisfied with this. I want to learn more. I want to grow. I want to prosper. I want my life to get better. And so, which is amazing, is you took the appropriate steps to get it, which is awesome. And I think that's because you paid a bit of a price of not having any initiative for too many years.
Oh, I did.
And you didn't want to go back.
No, and my life would have turned out to be a nothing life if I would have kept it at that pace.
Yep, yep. Yeah. Man, and so many people, Rebecca, it's so true. So many people think that the nothing life they have, that God has assigned them to that somehow. They've got into their head that this is the way that it is, and especially if they live around other people who have no initiative. If you've surrounded yourself and you live in an environment of a bunch of lazy people, man, you start to think like them, you eat like them, you do the same entertainment that they do, and then your life turns into what they have, and then you're convinced that's how everybody's life is. That's the family I came from. Oh my gosh, it's so the family that I came from. Love my family, don't want the lifestyle. Mm-mm. No, not the one I saw growing up. Everybody's very different today. I don't want that life that I saw growing up, no way. We got Teresa Horn from Florence, South Carolina. What's your thoughts on initiative?
Well, there's a lot of people that have it and a lot of people that don't.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the military from 1986 to 1990. I've seen both sides of the spectrum, and I've worked in a lot of different jobs, from restaurants and retail to warehouse with inventory control. I've seen some guys falling asleep on their forklifts in the warehouse and getting caught. Yeah. It was unreal. We had one guy at Walmart when I worked there. Like I put on the Facebook that he was one of these lazy people that tried to find ways to get out of doing stuff, and he ended up getting caught sleeping upstairs in the room where they have the shelves and the hooks and stuff, and he got fired. So, you know, you, like I said, you snooze, you lose.
Whoa! Hold on a second, Teresa! Someone sleeping on their forklift and another guy that goes upstairs and just has a nap?
Yep.
And you can only imagine what he told everybody. My boss hated me.
Yeah, exactly.
My boss hated me. You know, I was wrongfully fired. I'm like, oh. Every time I hear someone say that, I just go, you know, if there was a videotape available of all of your conduct for the last year at that job, what would it tell us? What would it show us? I'm not saying that some people don't get wrongfully fired. That does happen. However, it always seems to be these kind of people who are sleeping on the job, literally sleeping on the forklift. That seems a little dangerous.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Beat up on the steering wheel. And I was like, oh, I can't believe this.
Wow. That's amazing. Okay, we have to cut over to a quick break. Teresa, I want you to think of a story of someone with initiative and what that actually looks like instead of us because we can tell stories all day. Those are pretty funny. Someone falling asleep on a forklift. Lord, have mercy. And no, seriously, okay? That is the ultimate of 98%. The ultimate of 98% is how can I not work? That's the ultimate of it right there. That's a poverty mentality. That is a skirting all responsibility, shifting responsibility on other people, and expecting somehow to be rewarded. This does not create high value in the marketplace. And today we're going to help you see where you can create more value in the marketplace so you can get promoted again and again and again. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue after this.
Is initiative really that important? Can it really improve your life? Dani's going to break it down for you next on The Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. The most common question I get usually are from people who are trying to juggle their life. They've got kids. They've got kids who are involved in all kinds of activities. They've got business or their job, finances, trying to get out of debt, plus all their church activities and all the volunteer activities. And they're pulling their hair out going, how do I juggle this all? Man, I once lived just like that until I learned Time Secrets. Time Secrets showed me how to be able to cut my hours from 100 hours a week that I was working down to 20 hours a week and tripled my income as a direct result with what I learned. Time Secrets also showed me how to get my priorities in order, which healed up my marriage. And I became a mother that I was proud of versus becoming the mother I didn't want to be. And so if you feel like your world is running around in all kinds of different circles, you can fix that. Call 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880 for Time Secrets.
Change your habits, change your future. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Where there is no ownership, that's a sign of having no vision. I'm not talking about ownership like as in a car or a house. I'm talking about ownership of your own life and the destiny that is sitting out before you, calling you by your first, middle, and last name. I'm not talking about the job. I'm talking about you as a complete package. Yes, you have a work life. Yes, you have a home life. Yes, you have a relationship life. Yes, you have a health life. You are a body that has many different functions all within one physical self. And so when you have this one powerful component called initiative, you naturally take ownership in various different areas of your life. And so, for example, health being one of them, when someone does not have initiative, their health begins to go to hell in a handbasket. How and why? Because they somehow are just expecting that someone's going to fix them when they get sick, that somehow they're going to be somebody else's responsibility. No, your physical health is your own responsibility, just like your own money, your bank account is your own physical responsibility. Your job is your, you own that place, that you own that job, and you have to have a vision for that. And when you do not have vision, you do not have ownership. And where you don't have ownership, there is no commitment. Where there is no commitment, there's no focus, and then there is no persistence. And you have to have vision, ownership, commitment, focus, and determination, persistence, to hit at the end of the day, cross the finish line, win the race of success. Don't let somebody else's definition of success. Live your own. And that's your path. But the bottom line is, it all takes the same ingredients. It does. At the end of the day, success has these components, and initiative is one of them. And initiative is spurred on by taking ownership in your work instead of trying to pawn it off on somebody else. Joining me right now is Teresa from Florence, South Carolina. She was just sharing a story that in her job at Walmart, she actually caught somebody sleeping in the forklift and another guy just sleeping upstairs while he's being paid. He's thinking he should be paid to sleep. But now we're going to switch it over to, because she says she was in the military. She's worked various different jobs. She knows what initiative looks like as well. So what have you seen in somebody that has initiative, Teresa?
Well, when you have an initiative, you get a lot more accomplished and you feel much more, you know, better about yourself and teaching others how to take initiative to, you know, help you along the way.
Yeah.
I had a lot of mentors in the military that you know, taught me how to take initiative. And as a result of that, when I worked in a warehouse, not the Walmart warehouse, it wasn't a warehouse, it was just a store. I worked in a separate warehouse as an inventory control specialist. And I became the go-to person, not just for inventory control, but coming up with better ideas for forms for the foreman and the supervisors that made their job easier.
Yep.
And I got not only promoted as a special projects associate, but I was also the inventory control. So I kind of made another job for myself without knowing it.
Yep.
And got a raise on top of it.
Of course. And how does that feel to be on that side of it?
It felt good because you felt, you know, like you, there was purpose.
Yeah.
You know, you
And it does. It is that way. You know what I find to be interesting is that, because there's somebody right now that's listening to today's program that's kind of in a rut. And, you know, ruts can be really deceptive. You know, a rut feels like I'm not moving ahead. It feels like we're not going anywhere. You know, it's the glass ceiling that people talk about or the wall that you keep hitting. But in all reality, that oftentimes when we find ourselves in a rut, it's simply because we have hung up our initiative. We have. We've just stopped using that beautiful skill of putting in complete excellence, looking on how can I make things simpler? How can I make things better? How can I make things more prosperous for this company that I'm working for? How can I make everyone else's job easier? It could be even something as simple as having the initiative to smile at everybody when you're walking through your place of labor. That in itself, that is practicing initiative. Why? Because you're actually improving the day of those that you're working with. You seriously are. Just a smile in itself changes the environment. It doesn't just change your environment and your attitude, but it changes the environment and the attitudes of those that are around you. So even leading initiative with smiling, letting that be an initiative that you're leading in the workplace with, that's going to set you up with a better reputation there at work. Because if you don't smile, you're sucking the air oxygen right out of the room, and now people don't want to be around you. They think you don't like them. They think that you're a sourpuss and you're negative, and they'll do things to try to avoid you. But people feel that they can trust those that actually smile. They are more trustworthy, and they want to work with them. They want to be around them. They're more curious about those people. So that in itself, like, that is practicing some form of initiative. And there's many other things as well. I want to pull back Elizabeth up on the line because she's a business owner. Elizabeth, I want you to kind of point out, because let's just say that someone's driving down the road right now, they're listening to today's program about initiative, and they're kind of like the two guys that you hired, or girls, or whatever they were, that you had to fire. What does initiative look like for you? Like, how, as a business owner, right? Because you've had people that have had initiative that you've employed. What does that do for you?
Well, the person that has initiative, they come in, they want to know what the job is, and they're ready to go from day one. Mm-hmm. They're going to take their own initiative to learn the task, and you're not going to sit there and tell them what the next thing is. They find stuff to do. Mm-hmm. One lady I had work for me, I would walk out, come back 30 minutes later, she had done 10 tasks. I didn't have to stand there and tell her. She looked for something to do and already had it done before I even had to ask for it to be done.
Wow. Isn't that a love song?
That takes pressure off me. Yes. That's like, wow, you know.
Yes, that's like someone singing you a love song. That's like better than a big old steak meal. When somebody, like when you're not watching and that person is doing. It's very interesting. I was having a conversation with a multimillionaire recently, a friend of mine who made his first million after coming to First Steps to Success and has made tens of millions of dollars since then. We were talking about this recently. He's like, man, you know, when I leave town, it's very interesting to watch how when I leave town for, because he usually takes the summer off, and he says it's a completely different place, a completely different place when I come back. And what is that? There's some lack of initiative there. Instead of somebody going, okay, the boss is gone, the owner's gone, instead of doing like what your employee had done, she leaves for 30 minutes, she gets 10 tasks done. Instead, people are like, psh, you know the saying, dude, the cat is gone, the mice are gonna play. Oh, that is such a 98% attitude right there. Oh, or the boss is here, whoop, better turn it on. Huh, better turn on my smile, better make sure my shirt is pressed, better make sure that I'm doing everything right, better make sure that I'm showing that everything is good and I'm doing a great job. You know what's so funny is that your boss knows you're doing that when you're doing that. You got to treat everybody right all the time, everywhere. That can't be just a when that person's around, now you're extra positive and you're extra smiley and you're extra doing a good job just to show off in front of that one. There is a one that's always watching. There is a one that's always watching. I guarantee you, like my friend, man, if there was somebody in there that took the initiative to make sure that everyone's production stayed the same when he wasn't there, whoo, that person would be getting one heck of a giant, giant raise. Why? Because business owners, we value those people that help to continue with the initiatives of the business moving forward. And so when someone steps into that role and they make sure things stay consistent and they're getting done, oy, 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 high, high value. I know that today you learn how to get yourself a raise. I'm excited. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
Be sure to tell a friend about the Dani Johnson Show. It just might be the key to the breakthrough they need.
For families in Santa Pancha, Nicaragua, life is filled with fear and struggle. They don't have enough food for their kids, clean water is hard to find, and they're living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel on top of mining tunnels that could explode and sink at any moment. But a miracle is in the making, and you can be a part of transforming this village. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha to see how you can help. That's kingsransom.org. Kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha.
What multimillionaire do you know that volunteers their time to help ordinary people like you and me? There's only one. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
You know what I love about you is that you tap into this program because you want to improve yourself. You tap in. You and I have this appointment together every single day so that you and I can help each other move our lives forward. You help to hold me accountable, and I know that this program today especially helped to hold you accountable. Laziness is not an option for you. And going the way of 98% of the population, like we heard the guy that was sleeping on the forklift today, hello, that is not for you. But you could be on that road and not even realize it. Because if you're cutting corners and if you act different when the boss is around or the owner is around than when he's not or she is not around, then that is showing you have some conditional initiative. But I know this, there is a boss that's over you and I every day, and he's not a slave driver, but he loves to reward the work of our hands. And he loves to reward our attitudes, and he loves to reward our smile, because our smile makes a difference in other people's lives. He loves to reward us for the work that we're working working with diligent hands and excellence. That boss is always watching us every single day, sees our attitude. And when we're off, and if we've had not a right attitude, and if you were like anything like I was explaining earlier, purposely not doing something because I didn't feel like I was getting enough appreciation from my spouse in those early days, and we had all those babies running around, people pooping their diapers. I'm so glad that's over. It doesn't matter. We have got to always put forth and work as unto the greatest boss who birthed us, who called us qualified, who has a destiny for our life. And that destiny is a yes and amen. That a destiny is not a boring life filled in a rut, doing nothing with ourselves and being nobody. You have got a call on your life, and it is time to rise up in it. One of the callings that you have upon your life and something that you can initiate in your own office is doing something that we've initiated here, and that is putting purpose to our work, the purpose to money that we're generating with the work it is that we are doing. And what does that look like? Well, for example, there's extremely poor people that are in the world that you have never seen, that you've never touched, and I hope that you do. When you experience the extreme poor, you know that your heart, in your heart, you have to do something, because if you think you're poor, you ain't seen poor until you come with me to the deep parts of the jungle in Nicaragua, that place like Santa Pancha, where, I mean, we're talking no food, no water, no shelter, and people are trying to raise their children in this, also with no education, no future for their families. Talk about deep despair, depression, and hopelessness. But we can make a difference. Even for just $1, we can make a difference, and a bunch of us coming together with a dollar each to build a brand new home. Here at DaniJohnson.com, we use 100% of our resources, our profits, to be able to help build homes for the extreme poor, as well as help kids come out of the sex trade and to provide for orphans. Now, you can bring that kind of initiative into your workplace, adding purpose to the work that we do every day by taking just $1 out of every 10 that we make and helping someone get a brand new life. Imagine how awesome that would feel. Go to kingsransom.org for more information. Again, that's kingsransom.org, and find out more about Santa Pacha, Nicaragua, and join us on this adventure. Hope you enjoyed today's show. God bless you, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Did you hear that last segment? Do you know someone else who needs to hear it? Go to DaniJohnson.com, find today's show, and share it online. Join us every weekday at 7 a.m. for more insights that will help you get to the life you've always wanted.
Hi, welcome to the Dani Johnson YouTube channel. We're super excited to have you here. And every single week, we're going to make sure that you get awesome videos for your business, career, making more money, saving money, annihilating your debt, as well as helping you to handle those really tough problems that you have with people at home, as well as at work, and taking those really good relationships you already have and causing them to flourish and grow. All you have to do is click that subscribe button right down here. Click that and you'll be subscribed to an amazing community of people, as well as some great videos that will help to improve your life. Thanks so much for being here. Subscribe now would be good. Just click it. I know you can see it. It's somewhere down here. Okay, talk to you later. Bye.